you talk a lot about the techniques that can be used to overcome fear. What are some of the things that you've learned work especially well for people?
Well, I like just simple hacks, just simple steps forward that start to create momentum. I think one, you have to identify what's holding you back. So I think you have to say, what is that fear? One of the simplest hacks I like, I mean, I it's at the heart of why I wrote the book. It's that you have to give yourself permission. And change starts when you give yourself permission to imagine a new future and then you make it happen. It sounds really easy, but it's not. But it's a simple idea. One of the things I like is just a simple permission slip. You know, people may remember when they were, some people when they were in high school may have forged their mother's signature to get out of phys ed or gym. I was always too much of a fraidy cat to do that.
I didn't. I didn't get away with it either.
You didn't? But, Yeah. My older daughter was really good at it. She had my signature down. But I actually used to keep a stack of them on my desk at work, and I would give them to people who would, like, say, I'm afraid to try this, or they'd have 100 excuses why something couldn't happen, and go, like, just give yourself permission to just try it. Just try it. And I found that really is at the heart of it for each of us, just one small step forward to do something that you're afraid of. And it could be something that's scary only to you. It doesn't have to be jumping out of an airplane. It's something that's particularly intense for you.
So you're really talking about just take an action.
Yeah.
And start to build some momentum.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. In the book I talk about, I share some of my early efforts at this. For me, early on, it was overcoming shyness, being reserved, also an introvert. Yeah. And I would have to challenge myself. Like, it was scary to me to introduce myself to people. Mm-hmm. Now I do it a lot. I've made it part of my job, but if you're not shy, you don't know the pain sometimes that comes with, oh my gosh, like just saying hygiene and feeling awkward about it. Well, I would challenge myself. I'd say, I'm going to go to this event, a work event or whatever, and I'm going to meet one person. So normally I'd stand at the chip bowl. Instead of standing there, I'd say, I'm just going to go meet one person and then I can go home. Next time I'm going to meet two people and then I can go home. So it's just, I mean, little small hacks like that are what I found are the helpful steps to just kind of move you forward a bit.